Okay, so this is something I've wanted to do for a long time. You watch honeybees going into water puddles, drinking at the edge of a pond, at the edge of a river, and we all have friends who have swimming pools, and the honeybees seem to go to their swimming pool to get water from the edge of the pool. Sometimes it's a bird bath, so I decided to make this test. So on the left I have the pure filtered water, PUR, which is the name of the company that makes the filters, unfiltered well water, pond water, and chlorinated water, which represents the swimming pool. So what are the bees going to go to, and what will they use the most? The duration of this test is about 3 days. So at the end of this video, I'm going to show you what they preferred and what they went after. I was actually kind of surprised, because here on my property, we have, at least for the filtered water, it's the water that we drink. So it's ultra filtered, 99% filtered out lead and contaminants of any kind. So it's really clear. And that's the one that these bees are drinking from right here. So I just assumed they would all go after that water. But do bees really judge it? And then this bee right here, all the way to the right, this is the chlorinated water. And by chlorinated, I don't mean city water. I mean it's pool-treated water. So you might speculate that they take water from chlorinated sources and they use their tongues to paint it around the hive to disinfect it. Who knows? And of course, here we have a yellow jacket wasp that's also drinking this ultra-filtered water, which is in the container all the way to the left. So I thought honeybees were just like anything else. For example, my chickens. They just go wherever the water happens to be. Whenever they're thirsty, they drink it. Honeybees are much more discerning than that. In fact, honeybees will show up at a drinking spot like this one, and it's important to keep the drinking spot location consistent so the bees always know where to find it. But they'll actually show up and often taste test the water from another bee before they go about drinking it themselves. So it's always fun and interesting to watch them do this. Now you may think, and rightly so, that bees go out early in the morning when there's a heavy dew, and you'll see them licking the dew off of plants. They do go after puddles and drippings, especially if you've got a hose bib on the side of your house. It's a little bit leaky. You can often see honeybees there getting the drips. But always go the extra yard and make sure they have a nice shaded area in some cases, or at least a cool spot where they can go to get water. And bees do not like to get their feet wet while they're drinking. So if you've got a mash or something out that is soaked with water, or a sponge, for example, the bees will kind of land on that last because they're trying to stay dry while drinking, even though we often see them flipping into the water and buzzing around trying to get out again. Now, these drinkers are designed specifically for honeybees, but these are considered landing board entry feeders. So the surface that we're looking at here would normally be inserted into the hive, and this helps to prevent robbing by other bees. Now, of course, if any of these water sources had sugar content, the bees would go after that first, and they would be certain to empty that right away. But I'm just interested in their ability to pick out the highest quality water. In other words, do impurities in the water even bother the honeybees? And I found that out here. And of course, in the middle there, you can see that they've flipped on their backs and they're buzzing around in the water. These are designed with little stepping edges so that they do ultimately get out without a problem. So don't worry about those bees. They're going to get out just fine. And of course, we have the yellow jacket wasps mixed right in with the honeybees. Some people are concerned that when you set up a feeding station of any kind that there's fighting. There really isn't. This territory doesn't belong to the wasps or the honeybees or honeybees from various colonies. So there's no conflict here. They happily share watering holes. And so here's the result. If you recall all the way back at the beginning of this demo, you can see the various water levels, and we can see that the pure filtered water all the way on the left is their favorite source for water, and they've taken that right down. Unfiltered well water, which has a lot of iron content in it, is their second favorite choice. Chlorinated is their third. And pond water, believe it or not, was the last source they wanted to drink from. And the pond that I'm talking about, where this water sample was collected, is 120 feet across and it's 14 feet deep and is spring fed, so it was a really good source. So that's a simple test, and I hope you enjoyed it. I always wondered if they could tell water quality differences, and apparently they do. And we'll close out watching them buzz around here on the asters. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new.